First work on the program will be the Quintet for Horn and Strings in E-flat, Kerschel 407, by Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. Ignaz Leutgeb, who rose to fame as a horn player and to fortune as a cheesemonger, was abetted in both undertakings by the generous Mozart family. It was Father Leopold who lent Leutgeb the money to open his cheese shop in Vienna, and it was Wolfgang Amadeus who kept his friend well supplied with original music, specifically the four horn concertos, a separate concert rondo, and the quintet which we shall hear shortly, Kerschel 407. The manuscript pages of the concertos are eloquent testimony to Mozart's practical jokery. Obviously delighted to have a friend to tease rather than a patron to please, Mozart drew funny pictures of Leutgeb in the margins of one manuscript, and in another, printed the notes in alternating, purposely confusing, ink colors of blue, black, red, and green. With this quintet for horn and strings, Mozart restrained himself admirably. Apart from dubbing it Das Leutgebische and giving it the mildly eccentric scoring of two violas instead of the customary two violins, violin, cello, and horn, he let his high-spirited whimsy speak entirely through the music itself. The score for this work dates from about 1782, most likely from the blissful period just following Mozart's marriage to Constanze Weber. And now here are our artists, Barry Tuckwell horn, Arnold Steinhardt violin, Masako Yanagita, and Abraham Skernick violas, and Jerry Grossman cello, and we shall listen to the quintet for horn and strings in E-flat, Kerschel 407, by Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. The work is in three movements.
Thank you.
The Quintet for Horn and Strings in E-flat, Kürschel 407, by Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. We have heard Barry Tuckwell, horn, Arnold Steinhardt, violin, Masako Yanagita and Abraham Skernick, violas, and Jerry Grossman, cello. This performance coming to you from the Mostly Mozart Festival at Avery Fisher Hall in New York.